Hey. Hello. Welcome. Oh, hey. Sweet. Hello. Welcome to our stream. Maybe you could hear me, maybe you can't. Let's do it like that. OMG, why aren't you here? I'm gonna totally like... Let me just do that real quick. Hello. Yeah, why aren't you here? Where else are you supposed to be on a Wednesday night in New York City other than Wonderville? Home, apparently. Okay, I totally understand. Slightly sick is more sick than normal. Appreciate the safety and precaution. We will play in your honor. It's not like you're dead or anything, but you know. We got a solid group tonight. We got six teams, 30 people playing Killer Queen tonight. Hella average. Yeah. Oh, that was 2-0. Oh, shit. That was 2-0. Wow. I think we're doing 2 out of 3 tonight. Double elimination. Oh, wow. What the hell? Yo, OBS is sick. I don't need this. Is there any way to, Yeah. Okay, I'm playing. Shit. What if I don't want scene transitions on? I could do that. Oh, hello. That's pretty sick. Yeah, I want all that. Okay, hold on. I'm gonna go play real quick. We're back. We're back and better than ever. Blow this mic out. Pause. Let me just reduce this real quick. 5? No. 8? Maybe 8. Let's go 7. 7 looks good. 7 looks great. Okay, cool. Hey. Welcome back. Thanks for joining us. If anyone has any suggestions of what we could do better right now, that'd be sick. Totally open to any feedback, good or bad. Preferably good, but you know, I can't control you. It's a sick game between Tyler and Mad Dog. Oh, well, let's not do that. So if you're just tuning in, thank you for tuning in. This is Mad Dog on the mic playing Killer Queen at Wonderville every Wednesday at 7:30-ish. Honestly, we start pretty late, but we get through the tournament, so to speak, relatively soon. 7-11 is our peak, like KQ time. Anytime after that, it's sort of trash games, as we lovingly call them. As you can see on the screen right now. Yeah. What is up with? Okay, great. We're here every single Wednesday, Wonderville. I believe this is Bushwick or Bed-Stuy. A lovely crowd we have here, 30 people. Lively crew. Every single week we've had at least 2 or 3 new people show up, and we've had some repeat customers checking us out. Appreciate it. It's a big thing. The transition to Wednesday has been a great boon for our Killer Queen community. Skeptical at first, but honestly, I just want to say I'm sorry. I didn't believe, but man, Wednesday is a really good day. We have Mustafa, former old queen, old guard, queen of the old guard, at New York City, facing against Daphne. Talented speed warrior turned queen, a former teammate of Mustafa, really came up together. Queening now, truly, it's not a rivalry, but it could be. Again, they're great friends. I mean, the only competition they ever have is who could get the most free drinks from others, who could receive the most drinks from other people for free. Good competition, good lighthearted fun. It's looking pretty good for both teams so far. It's very even, honestly. Oh, yeah, very even for both teams. Even though Snail is out for blue right now, it's not really out of the tunnel just yet. One for Jade, 3 warriors for blue, 2 warriors for gold. Trying to look at another speed warrior, looks like. A pincer happening right now. It doesn't even need to be a pincer. Believe that was Alex P with the kill. Oh, not necessarily a shuffle, more of a nice hezzy up there, you know, throw some basketball terms at y'all. Okay, good pincer, not really a pincer. A lot of cleanup work. Alex just terrorizing Daph right now. Gonna get another warrior out middle. Blue. Oh my god, just a lot of death right there. 2 gold warriors to take it out, but Daph herself gets taken out. Oh no. It's a little pedal to the metal right there. It needs a little push. Again, oh. Solid kill by Rom. Up and comer. Super recent this year. Super recent player from this year. Good kill. Speed Warriors out for both teams. Honestly, Gold has 2 Speed Warriors. Double trouble. Oh, Good kill. Even once more. Snail really has moved. Gold with the advantage as they have an extra queen life. Oh, okay. Daft covering some options. Was able to secure that kill, but totally fine. Three warriors, two. Nice. Oh, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, you're doing something. You got out of that. A little funky. Good bump. Good bump. Good opportunistic kill. Snail, once again, back in the tunnel. Leading to blue, but not really. Blue's going to get a third warrior out. Oh, no. It's going flying into danger. Another good kill. It's an even game now. Queen's down to last life. Two warriors for both. Scratch that. Three warriors for blue. Hello. Hello. Oh. Damn. Yo, those clouds look delicious. Like actual food. Kind of look like a marshmallow fluff. Oh, a tunnel. Tunnel action going on. Oh, not going to happen. But in that instance, blue gets taken out. We'll complete a team wipe. Let's see what Daph is capable of doing to get her team out. Side killer. No one's there. Practice your hover transfers. You're just going to go for that? I guess so. You're going to get one out left. That warrior is unfortunately out of spot place. That warrior did not space that correctly. So it's going to go down. Queen should go that way. Yes. Again, no gate guarding from either team. So it means that it's going to be a lot of warriors coming up. A lot of warriors are dying. It could go to famine real quick, honestly. It's been 4 minutes so far. So every single minute, it goes fast. Every single minute, you're closer to famine. Hello. Oh, no. Oh, you're just tired? Okay. Gotta go to Snail for gold. Oh, Snail's looking great for gold. Daphne decided to go under the queen. Mustafa was prepared. Gets that kill. Gold up. 1-0. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-da-ba. Oh, hey, they have a bot. You tap that bot out. I see five people on the cap, okay? Okay, whoa. You think you can play around with that? You're just going to go up there? You're going to go the long way? Oh, side J. Oh, what a bump. What a bump. Oh, my God. Do it again. Do it again. Do it again. Round count coming up big. Oh, no. Snail, there you go. Coming up big. You're going to totally disregard the snail, though. Tunnel vision on screen. Aye, aye, aye. Snail, there you go. Anyone going to guard snail, Brian? You're not going to do it? You're not going to do it. It's fine. It's fine. You need a third warrior, though. That's what you want. Yep. Very biased commentary. Oh, my God. Going playing from the back foot. Warrior gets taken out. Warriors get taken out. Ooh. Yeah. Like with all games, the biggest decider is who's able to perform lockout better. Honestly, it's really a question of who understands what lockout is. Blue Queen gets taken out. Oh, that warrior is killing it. Rom doing a great job. good flight patterns. Blue Slicker got their speed up. Gold has everything currently. Oh, good escape. Use your terrain to your advantage. Again, very queen focused. It doesn't look like anyone cares about the snail that much. Moment like these where you're like, you just sit your ass on the snail and you guard the snail with your life and make some really good progress. It requires a lot of talk and communication, and in a bar environment like this one, it's kind of hard. Oh, beautiful. What a kill. Okay, just fly in there. Sure, why not? Rom's taking it upon himself to guard snail. Great. Blue skulls. One warrior for gold. Two warriors for gold. Oh, so bad. Oh my god. Just bad. Ooh. Not the greatest positioning for the warrior. Okay, gold's looking for another warrior out. No speed. No one's guarding that gate for them. Good kill. Blue only has one warrior though. Extra life. So that's two. They're going to get that warrior out. Nice. Feels very flowcharty. Everyone's kind of going through the motions. Not a whole lot of on the fly decision making, it feels like. So like, I don't have that gate, I want that gate. Okay, pincer? Nope. Ooh. You know, flying in this game is kind of akin to driving. You sort of like, because when you drive, you know where you are at all times. Like, you know the boundaries of your car, right? Some people don't know their boundaries of the warriors just yet. Totally fine. Blue takes that. Ties it up. Uno, uno. Tough stuff. Everyone's having a good time, though. We love to see that here. If any of you are really into Killer Queen but are not, if you're not tuned in to the larger Killer Queen community, want to give a shout out to the Salt Lake City community. They're going to throw a tournament this weekend, this Memorial Day weekend. I forgot what the name of the tournament was called. But we do have a few New Yorkers there in Salt Lake City currently, enjoying themselves, having a vacation. We'll be representing us at that tournament. So if you enjoy what we do here, if you enjoy camaraderie, if you enjoy like sports, but you don't enjoy like conventional sports, but you want to like root for a city and you're from New York, totally tune into their stream. Cheer the New York squad on. Cheer all of our like miscellaneous players on other squads. It'll be a good time. It'll also be a really good viewing experience if you're relatively new. You want to like learn how to play this game at a moderately high level. Okay, with a little bit of organized play, you know. Communications, just general strategy. Gold's looking great. They're going to get the snail off the rope, maybe? Bump middle. Yep. Okay. Blue has all wiped. Gold has three warriors. This is not looking great for blue, honestly. They're going to go middle left? No, they're going to go left. They're going to go middle. One kill. Two warriors. Oh no. Sorry, did you give out too much space? Oh no, just couldn't get away from that. Gold locked in. Strategy on par. Oh my god. Strategy is locked in. Oh no. Too far, too far, too far. Gold team takes it. one in the best of five. Or best of three. Sorry. We haven't seen any meat maps so far. Disappointing, to say the least. I believe we're on the second winner's bracket game, or the fourth winner's bracket game. Damn, they took it. How'd you steal it? That's a lot. Okay. Oh, I am on. Excuse me while I go downstairs to play.
Great.
Honestly, I think it was the camera that was the problem.
Did we get a new camera, or?
The one that you guys don't use, like the one in the middle of the room, I think causes it to freeze. So if we stream anything.
Oh yeah, you were telling me about that the other day. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, there's Pete. Pete in the chat.
Pete's in the chat.
Oh, Mike's hot. Why is the mic hot? Hi, Pete. I had it muted earlier. Somebody must have come up here and been commentating.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's cool.
Don't say anything you don't want the chat to hear.
True. But also, I should turn the mic down. Or put a noise gate on. Always assume a hot mic. True. That's true. I had it muted earlier. I'm going to put a noise gate on here, actually. Just so the music in the bar doesn't copyright claim us, hopefully. Okay, check, check. Getting levels. Okay, open threshold should be... That seems good. It's probably going to sound weird now, but we'd rather have it sound weird than get the channel claimed.
Manual labor.
Oh, yeah, doing all those extensions, yeah.
Every day.
I bet. Yeah. All right. Gate looks like it's doing its job then. So that's cool. Can also turn the mic down a bit. Sorry, I'm messing with some audio. Thank you. Who was that? Gino? Gino with a nice cap there on the queen. Couple kills, too. Gino's on fire. I know what happened. The stream information doc got removed in OBS. That's why the mixer looked so large. Gino, what did I say? He was playing hot. Gets that third queen kill. Jeffrey's team gonna go to meat here? Any meat enjoyers? Yeah, a slightly smaller night here. We've got six teams instead of our usual seven. Still running double elim because a six-team round robin is still more games than a seven-team DE. And we started a little late, so we just kind of wanted to get the show on the road and get to trash games, honestly. Best of threes do go quick, though. Okay, Gino's getting out. Kevin's gonna drop a queen life there, down to last. Blue team looking good on these berries. And Wyatt doing a good job of blocking them. But Kevin's gonna get his revenge there on that queen kill. Jeffrey's still got one egg, though. I'm not sure what Chex is looking for there. They can't get through. But hey, now Jeffrey's dropping down to his last life with a kill from Gino there. So both queens on last here. Five berries to go for the gold side, two for the blue side. See that win probability looking about 66. Oh, after that, it's looking much better. 75%+ for the blue side. One to go. Oh, and Kevin closes it out. Gets that final queen kill, which means we're going to go into our next set, which I am playing in. So I got to leave you guys. Hope you enjoy the rest of the stream.
Yeah, I don't want to like say if this is an okay place. That, but also.
Oh! Mm-hmm. Woo! Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Watching-ish.